coaching plays an important role in the life of students, because most of the parents have their own job, so they didn't focus on their child. So that's why the coaching is important, because most of the children didn't study own self, because they just waste their time on these social media platforms. And coaching is important, because with the help of coaching, most of the topics we can't understand by learning in the books. So with the help of teachers, they understand us in a simple way or a practical way to understand this topic by easy.
So it is a very sad thing. Parents just too busy their children. They're making a noise in the home, disturbing the parents.
Yeah.
So parents just get them busy and engaged in any work. They have the children join the coaching classes to spend the maximum number of their time at the coaching classes. They could be free at their home and they could do their desired work. Because the children, they find them, they are very disturbing.
Yes.
Coming to the point, coaching classes are necessary or not? See, coaching classes are not necessary. But you cannot completely ignore the coaching classes and their contribution in maintaining the standard of the education and improving it every year.
Yes.
You see, when you go to prepare any competitive exam, so it is very hard to face any competitive exam based upon the classes you attended and knowledge you collected in your school, because in school, the biggest drawback is the classes and the time duration for which it is conducted. Teachers, they have the responsibility, and as the thing, they have to come in the class and describe the things which will come into the exams. So the students are made to prepare according to the exams they will take further. So this is the main purpose. Exam which we give in school and colleges and the exam which we face, any government exam or any private exams, they are very difficult to crack it. Based upon the knowledge of 11th and 12th studied in school only, it is difficult today to clarify any IIT JEE exam or any medical entrance test. It is difficult. Therefore, the coaching and the contribution, it is immense in increasing the standard of the education. So the coaching classes, it's fine to have. This is the option for the students, because the students in 11th and 12th, they're not interested going to school. Why? Because the schools are not sincere toward their education. There are no proper classes are conducted.
Yeah.
And it is very complex for the student spending 6 hours, 5 hours in a school, then join the coaching classes. So it will consume a lot of their time. So the coaching classes are fine, but there should be a limit in the fee for both school and the coaching institution as well. It should be affordable.
Coaching classes are also important for regularity and targets, because
yeah,
as we know that if children are joining the coaching classes, so the teacher will give them regular homework and they will take their tests. So this will affect their studies and they will improve their studies. And sometimes the parents are not able to teach their children, so coaching classes are also important for them.
But in sometimes the coaching classes in coaching classes the teacher you give main questions, main points, but after that you will going to job, but you have no skills, so it is not good for you.
According to me, if we talk about the skills, so the coaching classes is not necessary for developing your skills. You can develop your skills by yourself and nobody can help. Yes, at some time you need a guidance for for the skill development, but if we talk about the skill development, so it is not necessary that we get the skill development from the coaching. The schools also have their schools also have to participate in that to develop the skills of a student, because the first priority every time a student have to give for their schools. So the schools also have to focus on the skills of the students, not only the coaching classes.
But in schools, 40 and 50 students, so teachers are not focusing you. So I think coaching classes, not focusing you, but So coaching classes is important, suppose your exam is coming and you don't learn anything. So teachers, you give main question answer, main points. You have no skills, you have no knowledge for this portion, and you just revision.
I think all students are not intelligent. Some students are less mind, so that's why coaching is important for them. Because of this, they learn techniques of studies.
Sometimes students join the coaching classes because they know very well that their coaching teachers also in the school teachers, so they get good marks and get the question paper, they join the coaching classes.
There is a management of a study at the coaching classes, we need to appreciate that. And you know, one thing I found lacking in the school, if one teacher was to do everything with the children, dealing with 50 students in the class itself, taking their test and checking the copy personally, individually, it is a very complex and very lengthy process for the teacher. Not talking about here, the biggest school like DPS, Mount Letra and another more top class schools where they have the management body completely. Teacher will only set the paper and it will take the test of the student, and there are some other faculties, they will check the copies of it. So just to take one test, there are many people working and just to check the copies and delivering the results. So if this thing, which is handover to one teacher itself, it becomes a very complicated process. Therefore, there are less number of tests and performance checking activities of the children which is found.
Coachings and tuitions are very important for those students whose parents are not educated enough, so they send their children to the coaching and tuition so that they study well there, because in schools there are high number of students in the class, so they don't understand every topic very deeply. So in coaching and tuitions they pay good attention to the students, and home tuitions are also available for the students, those who don't want to go outside and they are scared from going outside. But I think home tuitions is not good for the student because they don't understand how life is going outside. If you go outside, you will face the competition. You get to know about how other students performing and their learning styles. And at home, you learn yourself according to your comfort level. But the home tuitions are not very good idea. So if you want to study, you can go outside and learn.
It is complex for the student and the parents to send them to the coaching institution where number of students are studying. They want a personal attention and personal care or personal understanding from the teacher. Therefore, like it is nowhere bad if they hire any teacher which comes to take the home tuition. So like this is also a way to teach the student where 100% attention that goes to you. When you go in any coaching institution where 15 students sitting in the class and they all are studying, so it is not possible for the teacher to give personal attention to each and every student. But when your capacity to pay something more to the teacher, you can hire the teacher. Yeah. So like this is the option for the people, they are willing to pay more. So this is also the option. But here, I just want to come back why a student need to join the coaching classes. Because the time is fixed in their school half an hour. Half an hour is very limited amount of time which is given by the teacher to take the classes daily. If teacher takes any topic, wants to teach that, it takes a number of days to like complete a one chapter or one topic. It will take him or her 5 days, 6 days. So it becomes sometimes monotonous, right? It becomes boring for them. When the chapter which is finished within 1 or 2 days, if the lecture goes for 1 hour consecutively, at least the 1 hour should be the way. But the problem with our education system and the time management of the institution is they decide 5 hours to teach the student and quality timing is 4 hours, and in which the 6 and 7 subject they are conducting the classes for it. So only three or four subjects should be taught, and the teacher should be given a proper 1 hour to teach the student so that the topic could be covered within a time, and there should be tests and this all. So 1 hour is sufficient for the student, not more than that, because the problem arises with the student is the concentration,
yes,
distraction. So 1 hour is the best time, or 30 minutes if the teacher is given 5 to 10 minutes which are wasted and talking to the student, the student's wishing, and only 20 minutes of teaching. So 20 minutes are very less time. Therefore, the student, they join the coaching classes which has the time limit of 2 hours. They go there and attend the lectures for 2 hours. That is why they understand the things. The problem in a school, what teachers taught within half an hour, when the student comes back next day, they forget what they studied. So yes, if the lecture goes for 1 hour and 2 lectures, the complete topic is covered. So the student will be able to understand better.
They are not thinking about that he and she is not understanding well, they are weak in study. That because of these issues, students have to go coaching and they are spending their money. This because in coaching, this is an extra money I think they are spending on tuitions, because if they are providing a good study in school, it is very good for them. But because the teacher thinking in school, teacher always choose the number of the student that they are good in study. They sit in front of these benches, and those are not good at study. They are not focusing on them, what they are doing, what they are not doing. They are not understanding their feeling.
As long as teaching is a job for the teacher, the student would need definitely the coaching classes.
Sometimes children join coaching for their friends because they think that if they join coaching, so this will maintain their standard in society. And I think another impact of the joining coaching is because as we all know that school have many functions, many occasions school will conduct, so this will distract the mind of the student from their studies. So I think coaching are necessary for that purpose.
According to me, students join the coaching classes because when they went to school for the study, they don't feel very good because they feel that the teacher is not paying attention towards him or her. So they want, because the small students especially, they want personal attention because they are very small, so they always try to get the attraction of a teacher or anyone with whom they are. So that's why for the small children, coaching should be good.
As we know that the time period of school is 5 hours regularly, so it is not possible for the student to concentrate continuously 5 hours and giving their focus on each and every subject. So I think coaching is also helpful for this purpose.
Degradation of the educational standard that has come because teachers, they join private schools especially, and where they are offered very less amount as a salary. They go to do the job only because they could have some of the students from the class itself.
Yes.
To get the student in the personal coaching classes,
yes,
where they
sir.
Charge them more.
Yes.
This happens. So this is just not the responsibility considered by the teacher. It is just the way of earning money. See, nothing is bad in this. If the teacher who is operating his private teachers, especially government teachers, are not allowed to run their own coaching classes, they are not allowed. This is the rule. But private teacher, mostly this happens with them. If they have the personal coaching classes, the students, they are interested to join them. Then only that should be the way to get the students into their personal coaching classes. They can charge them more. But you know, many teachers, they teach less,
yes,
in the school, in their school classes. And if the students, they want to learn something more, they offer their personal coaching classes, their address to the student, they can come and learn that. So this is the wrong thing. Like, the teachers are there getting less money from the school management, and they are going to take maximum number of students. This is just the investment of their time to get the maximum return in the form of the student and their fee.
Yes.
So this concept is not appropriate. So this is the degradation of the standard in schools.
sir, I also have seen that the students who are going to the tuition to the school teachers, they're just giving the exam paper before one day of exam.
Yes.
So this is the wrong thing, because the students who have worked hard for the exam from the beginning, it is a partiality with them. So it is not good that, because they are giving the question paper before one day of exam, because they want that the student should not leave their closing classes, so they have the... So,
yeah. These are the students, they fail in their life.
As he said,
they can pass the exam, but they fail in their life.
As
yeah.
he said that, I also experienced this same thing. That's why I changed my school. I was in 6th class. That time, teacher gave exam before the exam, maths paper, English paper, and my friend, she told before the exam, before 5-10 minutes before the exam, she comes to me and tell me this question will surely come in exam and this, and I thought, how you know that? She said that my teacher told that I'm studying there, so, and when I see the paper, that questions are on the exam, so I thought it is not good, it is cheating with us. And students who are studying in nursery and PG classes, tuitions are not good for them, because that is not the age for coaching classes. Tuition should be, we should admit the students after 5th class, because then the topics are becomes difficult, so they have difficulty to understand that topic. But before the 5th class, topics are easy, and we can and in the schools we can understand the topic easily, and also our parents can teach us the topics.
Also, we see that teachers are also discriminate between the students. Those are studying in their tuition, they always pay attention on them, what you understand, what you not understand, and those are not joining their tuitions, so they are not thinking about them, because they think about that these students are giving me more money compared to them.
Yes, and after seeing this, students tell their parents that I also want to join the coaching, and then parents thought that if they admit their student to the coaching, they will get more marks in exam, and because of this greediness, they admit their student to the coaching. But it is not good, because if every student thought like that, coaching we learn high, so what is the use of schools? They become useless. So we should understand every topic in school very well. If we don't understand, then we should join the coaching, not for unnecessary.
SC said that the schools are more important than the coaching classes. According to me, if you have the passion to learn something, so it is not required that the schools or coachings are. So it is not required you have to go to schools and coachings to learn something. If you have the passion, you can learn anything from anywhere. According to me, it is not necessary to join the schools and the coaching. Many people never go school in their life, but they have the knowledge more than the educated person who have the degrees and knowledge. So it is not necessary to join the school and colleges and coachings to learn something.
See, I want to speak about it. Education is of two types. First is formal education, second is informal education. What you talked about, some successful people, they did not study well in the college, even if like they did not get the graduated degree from the colleges. Still, they are successful, they are multi-millionaire billionaires. There are two types of education. If you want to do a job in any MNC company or anywhere, the formal education, which is pretty much required, you should have certificate, you should have degree, and you should have the formal qualification. You should have passed the exam from any universities or any college. This is mandatory. If you do not have this So it is not possible for you to appear and enter first things. Many entrepreneurs, yeah, surely they are making their name fame and they're becoming famous through the social media. So like there is less qualification which is required and they can do wonders in their life. But majority of the students' population, just because of the parents' goals, because of they are not themselves clear about their aim, therefore they want to secure a very safe option for them. Therefore they get the formal education, thinking to become doctor, lawyer, engineer, attorney, accountant, they think like this way. So very, very rarely this happens with the students. They want to go into the creative field where the less formal education is required. Yes, you know, in technical education, if you want to become a scientist, you need to be technically very sound. You must do your engineering from anywhere, your formal qualification, your academic qualification, it should be excellent. So what is the process and what do you want to become? If you want to become a good doctor, you have to go through the process of 8 to 9 and 10 years of doing MBBS, then MS, then MD. So you have to go through with this process. So technical education is important to become a specialized person. And another side, if you want to become a businessman, entrepreneurs, like if you have less qualification, then also you have the option within less qualification, limited number of technical knowledge, you can make yourself stronger and become specialized in something. Sachin Tendulkar, Lata Mangeshkar in art, craft, there are many areas which are introducing these days. So with the less formal qualification, you can do wonders in that. So education, that is of two types. But in formal education, guidance is very important of the teachers, because eventually the teacher is going to give you marks. At the last, your CGPA, your percentages matters. There are some jobs and there are some criteria of the exam. If you got 60%, if you got 50%, any management exam, if you want to appear, you should have at least 50% and more than that. If you have 40% of the marks, you are not allowed to appear in the exam. If you want to do MBA, this is the criteria which is fixed for you. In any government job and their exam, they are very tough to give you. Like if you want to become an excellent engineer, join IIT, so the marks matters, your technical skill matters. And more important, see, coachings, and what is the job of the teacher? What is the work of the teacher? Apart from teaching the subjective knowledge, to guide them, to mend them, right? Guidance is the most important thing. Teachers are the mentors, right? If they are, apart from their syllabus, if they are guiding the students. See, to accept something is important, to accept the right thing is important, but to ignore some unnecessary thing is more than important than you do the right thing in this. Not what to avoid is important. Sometimes we don't know. Like if we have the influence or if we have the guidance of our elders, in most of the time students, they don't have, because their parents are illiterate, the area is not that developed where the people could suggest them something. So if they have the influence, if they have the guidance of any mentor or the teacher, they can flourish in their life. Professor Anand Kumar, he is a national asset, like Super 30, this is the movie which made upon him. Still he teaches. What he teaches to the student, he teaches the same thing, right, which students are studying at the other places as well, in Kota, right, students are studying the same thing. He teaches the education with the life lessons. Education becomes a fun for the student. Education becomes very interesting thing for the students. Students, they are desire to become an engineer, join IIT, they go there and he select only 30 students. So like the teachers are not only teaching the subject, but also they are guiding the student. And if this is the process of the learning, learning becomes fun. So this should happen. Nothing is bad in this. Yeah, go please.
There are many kinds of the coaching teachers, compare a student what education skills, like many kinds of the toppers, the coaching teachers for main focus for toppers, not weak student. he do not try to weak student how to improve your learning skills. So the comparison, big comparison for
comparison is always there, brother.
Nowadays it's like a trend of coaching. Each and every student wants to go coaching just by seeing their friend. But most of the students who wants to achieve something in their life, they also study on self. They just study by the internet. Most of the stuff of knowledge also be split on the internet, and we can study on that. So I don't think coaching is important for every student, each and every student. We can study at ourselves, and if we have a consistency of studying.
As we know that if children are scolded in school by teachers, so they think that the other children who are sitting in the class, they are very familiar and known to them. So this the teacher will scold him, so this will not affect on them. But in coaching classes, there are many students which are not known to the children. So if the coaching teacher has scolded that children in front of everyone, so this will also impact in their study. They think to get good marks and try to improve their study. So I think this will give the positive impact of the coaching classes on the student.
The teaching is not same in coachings and schools. They teach differently both the places, so we should pay attention on the school classes also.
I think there will be a maintenance between the coaching and school. We should join the coaching classes, but not for that teacher who studied in the school. So I think we should maintain our coaching and school.
According to me, it is not the responsibility of only the schools and the coaching classes, teachers. It is also the responsibility of the student to study very well. Nothing can work if the student is not studying. It is the fault of the student, not the teachers of the schools and teachers of the coaching. I have seen many students, they are going in very well, in very high, very good school, and even then they are going to the coaching, but they don't studying very well. So it is not the fault of the teachers of the schools and the coaches, it is the fault of the student.
Looking at the coaching industry today, it is $1 million business.
Yeah.
Like, there is a lot of amount of the revenue which is made by the coaching institutions. Schools are also starting to walk upon the same path where the coaching industries is running. Why? Because some of the schools, they have started the coaching classes in their school.
Yes, sir.
Itself. After the schools, children, they do not need to go anywhere to join the extra coaching classes. When school finishes at 1 p.m., so 1 to 4 o'clock, 3 hours, 2 hours, these are the fixed. Teachers, they teach students in the class. Same teachers, they are taking the coaching classes itself. So parents, they pay amount of fee to the schools. They are having to pay the same amount of fee as the coaching classes to the educational institutions. So, and educational institutions are paying still less money to the teachers. If the teacher is paid 15,000 rupees teaching in any school, the teacher is paid 3,000 rupees extra, giving 1 hour, 2 hour extra. And the teacher is a helpless person teaching in a school sometimes when the salary is not very high.
Yes.
So increasing the hike of 2,000 and 3,000, 5,000 rupees, it will attract the teacher, and the teacher gives 3 hours more. But how much money the school management is making more? So this is also happening, like coaching and training industry. It is very profitable industry, but it has a lot of amount of hard work involved in this. See, if you are not very well trained, if you are average teacher, you can get a job in any school and you can start teaching there. But to run a coaching classes, it is not the very easy task. You need to be excellent in subject of what you are teaching. student comes and go, they will stay with you when you have the ability to teach a student. Not only teaching is everything, dealing with the student is also a very important thing. In schools, teachers, they are talking to the students in a very rude way, and they're insulting them, they're mocking them, and some of you said they leak the paper and they give the more marks to the students, they come to their coaching classes to study there. So the motive of the teachers is to make a lot of money from the students, getting them joined their personal coaching classes, which is not good. Children who are not joining the coaching classes, it is a cheating with them. And children who are joining the coaching classes, it is also the cheating with them. They can get the good marks in exams, but life has a different question paper set for you.
Yes.
It is waiting for them. If you haven't done a hard work, if you haven't developed the hardworking nature, you will not be able to succeed in the competition. When we see the competition, which is increasing hell out of the way, like it is very difficult for us to compete. You can compete only when you match the skills or the hard work or the capacity to do the hard work. If you haven't done this in your school time, you would depend upon joining the teachers and getting the marks. And actually, it is not getting the marks, it is buying the marks.
Yeah.
You are paying the tuition fees and you are buying the marks. It is not good. You can buy the marks, but you cannot buy a good career for yourself.
Yes.
Because, you know, like studying and doing the hard work, it just trains you to handle the pressure. If you're not doing this, so the teachers, they are misleading the student sometime. Like, it is not good. What you study to train yourself for the upcoming challenges. If you skip this process, you are inviting the risk in your life.
Sometimes you just try to understand yourself. Sometimes you listen the song, but nobody learning you, but you learn it. So I think this is student fault, not a teacher.
If you want to join the coaching classes, so you should join the coaching classes from that teacher, which teachers are not in the schools. So I think this will keep your studies maintained, because if you are joining the coaching, as already said that if we are joining the coaching classes from that teacher, those are also in our school, so they will leak our paper. So I think because students need coaching classes also, so they should try to maintain the coaching institute, because there are many coaching institutes, so they should join their coaching where the teachers are different.
Also in coaching, in tuitions and schools, they are different because of if children want to get.
Now there are some courses to pursue the career and which is not taught in school.
Yes.
Suppose if you want to become a fashion designer,
yes,
mehndi artist, or some creative sections, extracurricular activities which are hardly appreciated by the government school and private schools. Yes, schools are charging you huge amount. They will provide you this opportunity, otherwise you are staying apart from this one. Like if you want to become a model, so there are training industries to train you this. What is the culture of this area? What you should learn, how kind of communication, what is the body of the management there, what are the requirements of the job profiles are there. So this everything is taught by coaching institutions. Like if girls, they are interested to become air hostess, right, loco pilot. So there are some coaching institutions specifically, they are teaching the culture of the different areas of the field. So it becomes important for the students to have the coaching classes if they want to join any creative section. Like for the traditional or the conservative options, schools are enough, or if moreover they want to join the coaching classes, it is fine, they can join it. But some important skills like tattooing, piercing, this is also altogether a different fashion industry. Fashion designing, dress designer. So like they are also introducing a very creative option and profitable option for the youngsters, and youngsters, they are fascinated by this. As you talked about Instagram, social media, right? So they are flourishing, and digital media. So there are some institutions which are separately working. Digital media, digital education, which is not given to you in schools. Colleges are providing this, but since we are talking about schools, so it is not, this knowledge is not provided. So you have to join a personal institution to teach you this skill.
Yes.
See, commerce students, they have this to study in 11th and 12th standard, but still they have to go through the process of doing the tally. Right? So there are institutes which are teaching. Practical educations are lacking in a school. Students, they are promised when they get admission in a school, they are promised they will be provided a computer education.
Yes.
But on the name of the computer, there are two computers and 50 students. It is not possible for the students. So the student, they have to pay a little bit extra to learn this accounting, tally and ERP, many
so
courses are there.
Tuition fees also.
Yeah.
Tuition fees.
Exactly.